if I had all my data and every American had all of their data, I think you'd see a couple of ecosystems arise. You'd have cloud providers come in and say, hey, give us your data and we'll add value to it. You'd have researchers come in and say, hey, give us your data and feel good about yourself. You're going to help us to cure cancer. And you may even have pharma come in and say, hey, give us your data and we'll give you money. I mean, it's your data. It has value to us and we want to compensate you for the value. Are we at a point now where there's enough momentum behind this, or are we still caught up, and you're a doctor as well, so are we still caught up in the, we don't want to give data to patients because they don't know what to do with it, which is, you know, the Judy quote that I think she got caught on, but that's a sentiment that I found talking to a lot of physicians. I'm trying to protect the patients. If they had this medical record, they might make the wrong decision. Where are we at on this?
Sure. So I think you are absolutely right. The era of consumer empowerment is here, and any restrictions on data flows are gone. Where Judy got in trouble and where I've got in trouble, I'll just tell you, it's because the intent of what we're meaning is just telling a patient their serum sodium is 139 isn't very exciting.
I have no idea what you just said.
So. Right, right. As opposed to saying, I'm going to fluidly give you all your data, but I'm also going to help you navigate the healthcare system, which is, here's how you make an appointment, and here's how you get a referral to a specialist, and oh, here's a machine learning plugin that's going to compare you to 10,000 people like you. I mean, those things of value, that's really what we want to have, not just a portal where you can read your serum sodium. So absolutely. Beth Israel Dickens has been sharing notes with patients for 5 years. Everything about you includes you. And we just started an initiative where you are writing the note that goes back to the medical record. And so the doctor could say, oh, I think you're depressed. And you could say, no, you know, I'm just, you know, not energetic and it's rainy or whatever. You know, you put in what you say, what you think as part of the medical record. So that's where we are.